So tomorrow and Friday are very similar to today. Warmth and sunshine in light winds. On Saturday, we warm up a few degrees as those winds turn more northeasterly. They're still light and it's still sunny. It all comes to an end on Sunday as milder air spreads through. This will turn to cooler air for Labor Day Monday and Tuesday too. In fact, it may be cool for much of next week, so I'd make the most of what we have now. Showers are possible on Sunday night, Monday and into Tuesday morning as well. But really, it doesn't produce much at all. This is all we can expect in the next 7 days. So that small amount may not be enough to break the dry spell. That'll take us to 44 days in a row with no significant rain. If so, it will be our fifth longest dry spell on record. The longest run was 56 days. That was 9 years ago. But this is the current guidance for later next week. There it is. It is a full week away, so rough guidance for now, but I'll be keeping an eye on those rainfall totals. Around the nation tomorrow, mostly dry in Sydney, Adelaide and Perth, warm with lots of sun. To Victoria, areas of fog in the south to start, otherwise sunny and warm. Winds are light east to northeasterly and have afternoon sea breezes at the coast. Closer in, a few spots may see fog at first tomorrow, but it clears out. We'll all be sunny and warm after that. The city starts on 15, reaches another top of 29. It is sunny. To the 8-day outlook, and there's another 29 to come. That one is on Friday. We zoom up on Saturday, I think a top of 32, still sunny. 28 on Sunday morning, cool change coming through during the afternoon, about 22 by late afternoon. Then the chance of some wet weather here. But next Thursday, there is the chance of some serious showers. So fog in some suburbs at first tomorrow, then all warm and sunny. Top of 29, Mitch.